Welcome to learn you and me. Here you can see active cell is getting highlighted automatically and also not erasing or deleting past cell color. In gross cell figures range, conditional format is applied and this will also highlight conditionally formatted range as you can see. You can choose your highlight color. Just press CTRL+SHIFT+C and choose color from color palette and press OK. As you can see, after this highlight color got changed. Let's change it again, pressing CTRL+SHIFT+C and choosing color, then pressing OK. As you can see, highlight color got changed. You can also disable this auto highlight. Press CTRL+SHIFT+D. Now after this active cell not getting highlighted. To enable highlighting, again press CTRL+SHIFT+D. As you can see, highlighting got activated. This will also work in another worksheet of the same workbook. Activating sheet 3, you can see active cell highlighting occurring. Basic idea is to first capture active cell address and store it in name manager. Second, dynamically create conditional formatting on active cell. Here, this formula is used for creating conditional formatting on active cell. Now, these above steps are repeated each time after activating new cell. But we also have to delete applied conditional format on past active cell. So steps now becomes, first delete conditional format of past active cell. Second, capture active cell address and store it in name manager. Third, dynamically create conditional formatting on active cell. Press Alt+F11 to open BVID. Here in this workbook module, you can see in workbook sheet selection change event, delete conditional format, record active cell address, create conditional format is called in series, and these subs are written in module 1. Here we have to delete conditional format before deactivation of a worksheet, hence called in workbook sheet deactivate event. Now we have to record active cell address after activating a sheet, hence record active cell and called in worksheet activate event. Here in module 1 you can see record active cell address subcode. Now here in name manager you can see this code outcome. Here you can see address name which is cell add and its value which is active cell absolute reference address. Here you can see J11 is active cell whose cell address is stored in name manager. Here you can see create conditional format subcode. This will apply conditional format on active cell dynamically. This last line is for highlighting or coloring conditional format cell. Here uncommenting this line to get formula for conditional format in immediate window. Here you can see formula. Let's understand this. As you can see, active cell address got stored in name manager. Disabling event for a moment. This cell function with address will give active cell address. Cell add will give stored active cell address. And testing equality. As you can see, this evaluates to true. Here you can see dynamically applied conditional format on active cell. This and condition and 1 is equal to 1 is there for making this formula unique. Here you can see how things are changing or applied dynamically behind the scene. To make it more clear, let's highlight active cell by applying conditional format manually. Here H11 is active cell. Press Alt+OD to apply conditional format on active cell. Here writing formula is equal to cell bracket address bracket close is equal to $H$11. Select format color. What is wrong? Let's see. Here $H$11 should be between double quotes. Here you can see active cell got highlighted. Now all this occurring automatically and dynamically behind the scene. Now I think you got working logic. This formula str is modulable constant declared at the top. Here you can see it is declared at modulable because formula str is referred by more than one subroutine. H color is public variable. Here you can see and represent the color number. Update color sub assign value to H color if H color value is lost for some reason. Here you can see update color sub. Highlight color value also got captured and stored in name manager. Here you can see this number represents this color. Now we will see how color sub or program works. Currently active cell highlight color value is 6750207. This number represents this color. Press Alt+F8, select change color and click options. As you can see, for running this sub, CTRL+SHIFT+C shortcut key is given. You can change this key to something else if you want. Now, to see its code, click on edit. Now running code lines one by one using F8 key. Select a color, then click on OK. Pressing F8. Here you can see new color value assigned to H color. This H color is used in create conditional formats sub or subroutine. Now here in name manager you can see new highlight color value is 65280. Now just select a new cell to see effect. As you can see, highlight cell color got changed. Let's see how disabling and enabling works. In name manager, here you can see value of this HT, disable highlight. Name is Y, which means highlight is enabled. Press Alt+F8. Select flag enable highlight. You can see this will run on pressing CTRL+SHIFT+D shortcut key. Let's see code and running it line by line using F8 key. As you can see, previous value of this HT is equal to Y. Now new value will be is equal to N, which means disable highlight. For highlight disabling, you have to also delete previous conditional format, and this new value will get stored in name manager. Here in name manager you can see new value. Here you can see this function will return false after disabling highlight, hence all these code lines not getting executed. Here you can see highlight enabled function. This will return false. As you can see, highlight is disabled. Now no highlighting taking place. Now enabling highlight by pressing CTRL+SHIFT+D. As you can see, highlighting of active cell occurring. Now I have stored this value in name manager. Alternatively, one can also store this value in specific cells instead of using name manager. Advantage of storing a value in name manager or in a cell is that variable value is retained even after closing workbook. Hence your program will behave as per its last setting even reopening the workbook. Make sure event is enabled for this program to work, and file download link is provided in the video description. After making video, I got idea to make flag enable highlight program more efficient. Here I added these two lines in this sub to make it more efficient. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, then please subscribe, like, comment and share.